offer the gods human souls, they were not going to give you back things. If you don't sacrifice to Huitzilopochtli, the god of war, they used to think that actually the sun was going to turn off and that the world was going to end. If you don't sacrifice Tlaloc, the god of rain, they thought that there would not be any rain here and that this will be dry land. And obviously, if it's dry land, you don't have food for your people. Okay? The same happened for the god of fertility, for the god of war, for all of these different types of gods, guys. This is why we have to sacrifice. To pay the gods back, and the gods will give you things back. The things that coexist in nature, naturally. Okay? And if anybody feels maybe bad energy or bad weight on you when you're right here, guys, if you feel energy, because obviously not one person will sacrifice. Not 100, not 1,000, not 50, not 20, not 40,000. Each year, since they started construction in the year 1430s, up to the year 1521 that civilization fell, there's chronicles that said that that every year they sacrificed between 10 to 20,000 people right here. So if you feel bad energies, well, now you know why. Okay? And I'm a really big fan of the Aztec history, all of the pre-Hispanic history. If I'm not a big fan of honesty about of this history, it's of the human sacrifice. Okay? I don't know if you're big fans of being sacrificed, okay? But if you are big fans, well, this was the spot 100 years ago, guys. Okay? This was the spot where these practices.
Did the really have these scholars?
They really had these scholars. Exactly. They did have these scholars. Actually, the pigment red. On these sculptures. You see these sculptures? These are actually painted. And I don't know if you see that they're painted red, okay? That is a color that comes from a plant of a cactus called el nopal, and it's called Grana Cochinilla, okay? When they extract this, it's like a disease of the nopal. It practically gives a red juice that looks like blood, okay? And so it's a really permanent pigment. Imagine that has lasted more than 600 years, okay? And another fun fact,
Go ahead, Fred. I was going to ask about, are there any stories of, like, ghost stories here? Because so many people died. Yeah.
Look, legend says that on these buildings were phenomenal homes. Legend says that they got to hear things, they got to hear voices, and they got to see ghosts. I don't know if it's entirely true, but maybe it is, because this is where people were sleeping for hundreds of years, and nobody knew they were sleeping above this. Obviously, the Spanish that built it and destroyed it, they knew this, okay? But with the passing of years, they got to forget where this was. Okay? And also, as a fun fact, I think we already tried the dish called pozole. Mm-hmm. Have you guys tried pozole? Pozole is a Mexican dish I really recommend you guys to try. It's practically a soup of pork. And on this soup, they put different peppers. They put peppers, they put chicken meat, they put pork meat, they put lettuce, they put onions, and oregano. Okay? It's a really, really good dish. One of Mexico's top 10 dishes. I recommend you guys try it, okay? I like to say this story as a fun fact because this dish was invented by the Aztecs. But guess what? At that time, we did not have, there wasn't forks. There wasn't any forks here in Mexico and then in America. There wasn't any chicken. So where did they get the meat from? The human.
Oh, okay.
Man. After they practice human sacrifices, the best parties are going to be used to prepare this dish. And the only people that can get to eat it is not normal people. Only the high class of the Aztecs decide to get to prepare this dish. They say that human meat tastes identical to food. Don't try that, obviously. We do not prepare it, obviously, with human meat anymore, guys. This is why I recommend you guys completely trying this dish. It's really good. And it's an Aztec dish, okay? So don't be scared. And now the last fun fact before we go on. Some people ask, well, what is it that happened if they built such a big pyramid? What happened to all of this pyramid? Well, guess what? After the Spanish arrived, they destroyed it. And they were going to recycle the same material to build another religious temple. But this time it was not a Aztec religion. It was a Catholic religion. And where the material that used to belong here ended, it actually ended right there. On the first stage of the construction of the cathedral. You can see how those rocks look identical to the rocks that we have right here. And because of that, used to belong right here. Okay? So this happens a lot. And like this is destroy one religion.
Now we're going to go to the next question.
It's still a red dot, right? Nope. No, you just can't see. Pásale. Oh, there's beer here.